In today's session, I am going to show you how to integrate QuickBooks with Zoho CRM or Zoho Books. Zoho created for us a beautiful system named Zoho Flow. Zoho Flow is like Zapier, Automate.io. It's a system that grabs information from one system and push it into a different one. There are endless combinations that you can run using Zoho Flow, Zapier, Automate.io, and so on. If you have the Zoho One license, you will not need to pay extra for Zoho Flow. Let's see how it works. First of all, I will need to add Zoho Flow into my applications. Let's see if I have Zoho Flow enabled. Yes, I have it enabled. If you don't have it enabled, you will need to click on Add Applications, and you will need to add Zoho Flow to your list, and you will do it from here. You will just click on Add, and then Zoho Flow will be added into your list. Then you will need to click on Zoho Flow. You will need to click on Create Flow. Let's name it Zoho Books to Zoho Books to QuickBooks. Let's click on Create. Okay, let's do next. Okay. First of all, I will need to click on the app and I need to configure where the data is coming from. In my case, it will be Zoho Books. And let's click on Zoho Books and click Next. Now, the system is asking me, what do I want to get from Zoho Books? And in my case, it will be, let's say, a new contact. Whenever a new contact is being created in my Zoho Books, I want it to be pushed into my QuickBooks. Then I will click on Next. Now, the system is asking me to connect my Zoho Books with Zoho Flow. I will give it a connection. And I will need to generate an auth token. Just let me just show you what I just did. I just clicked here on generate auth token, and then the system opened Zoho Books, and then I will just click. In order to create a token, you will need to click on generate auth token, and then you will click on generate token. Copy the information and just paste it into Zoho Flow and click on authorize. Now, the system will need to know what organization am I using, because in some cases, Zoho Books will have more than one organization. It will not happen too often, but it might happen. And I will select my only organization and I'm clicking on done. Now I have the entry point. Whenever Zoho Books will have a new contact, this workflow will take place. Next, I need to search here the application QuickBooks. I will click on the dropdown and I will click on Create Customer. I will drag and drop into the board and I will click on Connect. I will click the connection. And I will click on authorize. QuickBooks will now ask me to log into my QuickBooks account. I will pause the video because I don't want you to see my QuickBooks. Whenever I will finish logging into the account, I will resume the video. Okay, I just connected with my QuickBooks. And now I need to map the information. The information on the left side will be my QuickBooks fields. All those are QuickBooks fields. On the right side, those will be the Zoho Books fields, the Zoho contact fields. I will need to go here, let's say fully qualified name. I will click on the field and I will search here let's say name, company name. And now you can see that the system just pasted here the variable. The contact display name will be the same that I have in Zoho Books. I don't need the family name. Company name will be company name. Email address, let's write here, not here. Email address, let me just click here. Email address, and then I will go all over the QuickBooks contact fields and I will fill them. Whenever I'm done, I will click on done. And now I have the integration. Next, I will need to click here on save. And then I will need to mark your workflow is on. Now this workflow is on. Whenever this rule takes place, whenever a new contact is being created on Zoho Books, it will push the customer into QuickBooks. Now, there is something cool that you can do here. If you click on the logic, you can create here a decision, which means, let me just do it like that. I can say, for example, whenever a new contact is being created, and I will click on the condition, and the condition is that the email is not empty. One second. Email. If the email is not empty, then create my customer on QuickBooks. If the email will be empty, this contact will not be created on my QuickBooks. That's the decision. So just know that this is also an option, but if you don't want, you can remove it. I will click on apply changes. And now you're ready to go. That's all you need to do in order to integrate your QuickBooks. Of course that you can also create the invoices the same way, purchase orders, quotes, estimates, everything can be done exactly in the same way. You just need to select in Zoho Books, you need to select the invoice, for example, and in QuickBooks, you need to select the invoice. Whatever you choose in Zoho Books, you need to do the same for QuickBooks. That was an example of how to integrate Zoho Books, but just know that you can do the same thing for Zoho CRM. You can integrate Zoho CRM invoices or contacts with QuickBooks. It's exactly the same thing. The integration doesn't care what will be the initiation process, if it will be Zoho Books or Zoho CRM. The system only needs to get the variables, the data. Once the data is being pulled into Zoho Flow, Zoho Flow can push it into almost any application. In our case, it will be QuickBooks. I hope that this session helped you, because I saw lots and lots of people that asking how to integrate QuickBooks. So here you go. That's how you do it. See you in the next session.